It should be live. Just start by talking to myself. This is not what you think it is. Actually meant to be a human body, a procedural animation. As we ask it to answer in the chat, generate continuous code, which it did. It did ignore the answering in the chat bit. HTML, JavaScript, JSON, CSS, interactive simulation game. Fully working, yeah, obviously. No code placeholders, yeah, which it didn't do any placeholders, that's good. Text overview at the bottom of the page, yes. Instructions at the bottom of the page, feature improvements at the bottom of the page, yes, did all that, didn't ignore that. It's a procedural animation of human body that can walk around using keyboard and following the mouse, yeah, the following the mouse bit is not quite there. Anatomically accurate, yeah, not sure. Controls for gait. Yes, we have stride, cadence, hip sway. Yeah, this does this funny thing with the mouse. Stride, yeah, does that weird thing when the stride is too low to restart it. Yeah, there's couple of things. What we're trying to figure out though, should we just go for a single shot prompt? Controls for gait. Yeah, the issues might be not clear. 3D body, realistic joint limits, falling balance if misstepping. Yeah, okay, there's quite a few things. It's working backwards. The mouse is a bit funny. It's meant to be turning sideways. Let's see. Okay, can we chat about this code real quick? There's a few issues with it. Can you start with one sentence? Response, quick responses.
Of course. Let's dive right in. What specific issues are you noticing?
Yeah, the mouse control is weird. The walking, the keyboard seem to be backward.
Got it. All right, let's fix those controls. We can reduce the mouse sensitivity and check the keyboard direction logic so forward and backward movements match expectations. Want me to tweak those values and update the code for you?
Yeah, but there's quite a few issues. The mouse control is totally out of whack. There's also something wrong with the stride. The stride, when turned to the lowest setting, the whole character, the 3D character, is all getting into like a fourth dimension or something. Something weird is happening. So there's that. Then there is the character is actually, the figure is not on the floor. It's like halfway through the floor.
Thanks for the details. Let's tackle these issues one by one. We can adjust the mouse sensitivity so it's smoother, fix the stride parameters so it doesn't distort the character, and ensure the figure stands properly on the floor. I'll tweak the code to correct these behaviors. Sound good?
The mouse, it's not about the mouse sensitivity. There's something really wrong with the mouse control in general. We might want to redo the whole thing. I also don't like the locking of the cursor. What's that all about? Yeah, can we get rid of that as well?
Absolutely. If the mouse control feels fundamentally off, we can rethink how it's handled. Maybe switch from pointer lock to a more intuitive camera or character orientation system. We can definitely remove the cursor lock to make it more user-friendly and avoid that trapped feeling. Let's update the control scheme and refine the interactions.
Okay, are you updating the code?
Yes, I'll update the code to remove pointer lock, simplify the mouse control, and fix the other issues you mentioned. Give me a moment to make those adjustments.
Did you generate another canvas or something? Did you generate another canvas?
I didn't generate another canvas yet, but I can definitely update the code in the existing file to reflect all the changes we discussed. Let me handle that for you right now.
Yeah, I don't think it's actually... Have you finished generating the code? I'm not sure. I think you added another canvas. Can you generate the code in the chat? Regenerate the whole thing in the chat?
Sure. Let me provide the updated code right here in the chat. I'll integrate the fixes to the mouse controls, remove pointer lock, and adjust the stride and floor alignment issues. Here we go. Document HTML audio titled Generate Continuous Code. Here's a single piece of code with all the updates we discussed. Make nothing special. The text area is small, canvas is margins completely black, cursor is always vertical. With styles organized among them, we barely need anything else. First, basic styles text. HTML and body matter.
Okay, let's go. It's out of whack. It actually did start generating the code, which I didn't think the voice model will be able to do. We have like two canvases. Yeah. It's the problem of having too many developers on the project. So how many do we have? Yeah, we have all. Why only four? All? Doesn't support it. The other models don't support audio. Okay. So which one are we using now? I thought all three can do everything. And it didn't finish. Yeah, can you regenerate from scratch all the code as with the changes as per the discussion above? And we are using all three at the moment. Yeah, I don't like the mouse controls and everything like that. It's just a bit awkward. It's really awkward to control. Yeah, I have to move the mouse and use the keyboard, which is fine, but the way then the mouse it gets locked. Have the hips way working okay. The knee lift. Yeah, now it's not moving its knees at all. And we have it's doing something with the knees. It's not turning or anything.
All set. I've replaced the original file in the canvas with a fresh, fully working version that removes pointer lock and introduces simple click and drag yaw control, fixes keyboard mapping so KBWASD behave intuitively, constrains stride to prevent model distortions, seats the avatar firmly on the floor, no more half sync.
Yeah, we're able to fix that bug in Visual Studio Code. Then we have to do it again. Right, I actually had to stop the deploy. So it's trying to deploy the thing on its own server as well. Okay, now it's actually working. It's a weird, yeah, it's a really weird mouse control. Let's try it. That seems legit. Hips way. It's swaying the hips, but can you lift your knees up? Lift your knees up. Help us. Ooh, just went through. Through the screen. The shadow. Yeah. Okay, can we go over this thing quickly? What changes did you make? Just a quick response and question.
Sure. I added an import map to ensure the 3 module is correctly resolved from the CDN, preventing the module resolution error. Everything else remains the same.
That's fine. Let's talk about the actual simulation.
Sure thing. Let's dive into the simulation details. What aspect of the simulation would you like to focus on first?
Yeah, the controls are still a bit weird. I don't quite understand how to control this thing.
Got it. The current controls let you click and drag the mouse to rotate the character horizontally and use the WASD and D keys to move forward, backward, and sideways. If that still feels awkward, we can refine the rotation sensitivity or change the control scheme entirely. What would make it more intuitive for you?
Yeah, the walking with the keyboard is fine. I think the problem is that when we rotate, it's not actually rotating the character, it's rotating the whole viewpoint of the whole scene. Can you double check that?
Ah, I see what you mean. It sounds like the camera rotation is affecting the entire scene instead of just rotating the character independently. We can adjust the logic so that only the character model rotates based on mouse input, while the camera stays fixed or follows the character from a consistent viewpoint. I'll make that adjustment to ensure the character rotates independently of the camera.
Yeah, we only got 15 minutes left with the voice model, even though we are paying for this. That's okay. It will just, in theory, just downgrade us to the previous model or something. Okay, can you update the code to address the mouse control of the character? Can you update the current cadence? canvas, make sure you updating the correct canvas is the one that is currently open. Not sure if you can tell which one is which. I had some trouble with the canvas selection before. It's kind of hopeless asking the questions about itself.
Mouse drag now turns just the avatar, while a chase camera follows smoothly from behind, no more spinning the entire scene. Try the updated controls and let me know how they feel.
Okay, so everything seemed to stride. Okay, so stride seemed to be working correctly. A cadence. Yeah, probably correct. Not entirely sure. Maybe you can just explain the difference between them. Yeah, maybe just in the where the code is at the bottom of the page. Can we add more explanation about each one of the controls, the details about it? The hip sway seemed to act correctly as well. The knee lift, I'm not entirely sure, even if it's there, it's very minor change. So any suggestions as to how this can be addressed would be greatly appreciated. Yeah. We walked away from the panel.
I added a control details section that explains stride, cadence, hip sway, knee lift, and turn speed, plus a tip about boosting knee articulation. The knee lift slider's range now extends to 0.6, and its effect is amplified 1.5 times in the Gait code, so higher values give a noticeably higher thigh raise. Give the updated file a spin and let me know if the explanations and knee motion feel right.
Okay, there are a couple of things. Yeah, the info is okay. The knees are better now. There is with the mouse control, is there any chance I can view the character walking sideways? Yeah, we need to somehow, if any suggestions, need to improve the control of the character, but I should be able to see it walking back and forth. Currently back and forth keyboard shortcuts are doing the same thing, and then the other problem with that is that I can with the control, the mouse control, that I cannot view the character moving sideways. I'm not sure how would you suggest addressing that. The idea is that we would eventually like to add an obstacle on the panel within that within the room, and see how the character is getting over it. I guess we have to stop. Let's actually run it locally as well. Wait, that's the previous version, is it? Not sure. Okay, you can actually walk out of the room over there.
Stride, step length, how far the foot swings forward back. Cadence, step rate, steps per second. Speed equals stride, cadence, viewing the walk from the side. Right drag or tap QE now orbits the camera independently of the avatar, so you can swing the view 90 degrees and watch side on while the character sidesteps or walks forward back. Does that solve the see it walking sideways need, or would you prefer a one key side view toggle instead? Y, W, and S may feel the same because the camera can orbit anywhere. Forward is always the direction the avatar is facing. If you're viewing from the front, W makes the character walk toward you and S walks away. From the side, WS move it left, right, relative to your screen. If you'd like screen space forward, back, the way third person shooters work, we can add that as an alternate mode. Next step, obstacles. When you're ready to test clearance or stepping over objects, I suggest 1, drop in obstacles. Press a key to spawn a box at the avatar's feet. 2, simple collision detection that lifts the swing foot if it would hit a box, proof of concept step over. 3, a toggle to show the contact volume so you can debug foot obstacle interactions. Let me know, do you want a quick side view hotkey? Should we add the obstacle prototype now or refine the controls first?
Yeah, lots of good questions. Yeah, this will be a very long project. This will be a very long project. Which programmer is the best? Yeah, we have to obviously start the new chat.